most gracious, the most merciful, and who is the honor of the whole universe. And he endued all the creature with special ability by his perfect power. I'm very thankful to my Lord for giving me this ability that I'm speaking in front of you, and then my esteemed teacher for giving me this opportunity to express my views on the topic challenges faced by Muslim Ummah. Mr. President, Allah has conferred the Muslim with countless blessings and resources, and he provided them with numerous resources in the form of oil and natural gas. Despite tremendous resources, the Muslim Ummah is in shadow. Nowadays, the Muslim world is facing grave political, socio-economic, cultural, and scientific challenges with implications for its unity, peace, security, and development. Muslims are killed mercilessly. The Indian Muslims are in distress. Kashmiris are under the Indian siege for the last 11 months. Trump and his allies are ready to capture the whole of Jerusalem. There is fear of civil war in Afghanistan. Muslims are killed every year. Their children became orphans, their wives became widows, and millions of Muslims left their home to become refugees. But dear sir, I am gonna ask this question from all the Muslims. Why Muslims all over the world are in disarray and in shadow? This is due to the disunity of the Muslim. They forgot the noble and sacred lesson of Islam. Today's Muslims are suffering from numerous problems, and the basic reasons for their plight are the sectarian hatred, greed, prejudices, lust for power, intolerance, and many other materialistic interests. Mr. President, in such critical circumstances, I urge all the Muslim leaders to become united and identify their enemies. We need to establish the religious, educational, social, and political institutions throughout the world to make progress in every field of life. Muslims can regain your lost glory by strictly following the teaching of Islam. God bless you. Thank you so much, sir.